What is going on in the lab right now is we are in an incubation period. We're doing enzyme immunoassays, which is a fancy word for measuring hormones. The new thing that we've come up with is a procedure which allows us to collect a different type of non-invasive biomarker, a hair sample. What we do is we collect the hair and we wash it and get rid of all kinds of impurities. And then we will grind it down.
After grinding it into fine powder, it will be easier to extract the hormones from the hair samples.
And then we will extract it, and then just measure it as though it's any other type of biofluid. One of the big advantages of using hair over saliva, it really depends on the context. Whatever's going on in your body is going to just naturally get into your saliva. But it's going to get into it at that particular moment, every single moment. So when you provide a saliva sample, I'm getting a snapshot of that hormone level at that exact moment. But sometimes those momentary fluctuations end up being a problem. And what we really want is we just want to know what's your hormone level, kind of regardless of the context that you're in. And that's what hair gives us. Hair gives us about 1 centimeter of growth represents a month of hormone exposure. And so when we're interested in things that change slowly, then hair ends up being really, really useful for capturing that slow growth or that slow change over years instead of over moments. And we're really one of the first labs that's doing that. And we are definitely at the forefront of being the first lab to be measuring sex hormones or pubertal hormones in your hair samples. So if you look around the lab, we're doing a lot of our own samples and a lot of our own assays, but we're also a biocore for a lot of different universities to send us their samples so that we can serve as really a center that allows lots of different people access to biobehavioral research. I think it's been rewarding because now Iowa State gets to be known as a real biocore for developmental research that's biobehavioral oriented.